Quick question, how many of you believe that we are actually animals, or more precisely monkeys? How many of you believe that strongly? 20%. 80% of you think you're not monkeys. Okay, let's take a scenario. A kid was born, not conditioned, not trained, continues to grow. What will he turn out to be? A human or a monkey? I'm saying there is nothing, no training, no conditioning. Mowgli, Mowgli. Mowgli is a monkey or a human? Mostly monkey. All right? It's just that they make him wear something. The point is, we are in this belief that we are not monkeys, and that's why we are flawed in our own thinking. We should just accept that we are monkeys, and that's when we'll be this guy who is thinking monkey. Okay? And like he says, don't think. Well, most people actually don't think. All right? This is where we are. All right? This is how Varun's brain looks like. This is the don't think part. All right? Which is fight or flight, eat, sleep, sex, simple life, very animalistic. This is the emotional brain, where he got that love feeling, that romance ka jo baat kar raha tha. Suddenly started feeling romantic and love songs and all that, came from here. And this is all that which is making us think all the time. All right? As we grow up, so when we are kids, we are like this. Then we become like this. As we mature and become adults, this part takes over. And that's when we start getting very rational. Right? For example, right now you're judging. Ye kya bakwas kar raha hai? Is it making sense? You're judging me right now. That's your green part talking to you. All right? By the way, the green part talks to this guy. All right? And that's why we have this dual system. All right? The first system is saying that khana free hai, thoda extra khalu. Or I'm saying that, hey, this girl looks pretty, should I just stare one more time? And the good side is saying that, dude, you can't do that. Like, just stay human. I'll tell you, we can't even laugh properly. Because the other side is like, you know how stupid it looks when you laugh like this? We don't do that. Although we would be very happy if we did that. But we don't, right? We have been conditioned, trained through parents, education, jobs, to be a great machine, right, which works. What is this system? So there are two systems. One is that system which is dil to bachcha hai ji, right? That bachcha is that reptilian brain, the limbic brain, which is constantly having these great ideas. I want to do skydiving. And the rational brain will say, boss, chutti kidhar hai? There is no vacation, there is no budget, and then there is no motivation. And will my wife allow that, right? All those kind of things. And what will people think if I do something like that? So here's an example of proving that there are two brains. You see different sizes. I'm sure you've seen some of the optical illusions. The bottom line definitely is bigger, right? But it's not. It's not. It's not. It's not. Even if you're looking at this, your system is telling you, ye toh bada hai. But the system two is rationalizing and saying, no, it's not true. We have this two parts to our brain, and I can give you n number of examples of that, right? The first brain, I'll give you a better example. How many of you mugged up the multiplication tables when we were in school? Like, thoroughly. Okay, that was training of that to go right into your embedded system. So that someone will tell you, this you will just blurt out. You did not think, right? Magic. And that's what we say, learn it by heart. Well, by heart is that core system. There is nothing that heart has no memory storage function. Coming to the core point, I'm just establishing the fact there is this system one and there is this system two. System one is this impulsive, quick thinker, subconscious, always alive even when you are sleeping. Gets out when you have alcohol. You know what I'm talking about. And you know what? Have you seen a guy who's had alcohol? He's happy. And I'll tell you why. Because there's no rational mind telling him, dude, What are you doing? Your shirt is out. You have dropped this food out. No one is telling you this, right? So we have these two systems, right? And take my word for it, because these are all guys who have got Nobel Prizes for all the same theory that I'm talking about. So take my word for it. This is an example, right? If I had given the same information to you in a huge spreadsheet, it'll take a long time for you to process. But a chart, system one says, boss, Flipkart is going above Snapdeal in this period of time. That's what charts do. That's why management will say, can you put it in a chart and give it to me? Because they don't have time, they want to process information in 2 seconds. So, some text for you. This is the only slide which has some text. So it gives you an understanding of unconscious, effortless, automatic, and there is deliberate, conscious, effortful, the mask that we wear, right? The mask that we wear. I'll tell you one interesting thing. Anything that we do which has an animalistic trait to our behavior, we do it behind closed doors. And you must have all thought about all the things I'm talking about. All the things where we look like an animal, right? The problem with that is that we have come to the belief that 80% of us do not believe we are monkeys. Right? I don't know what 20% did to believe that. I'm sure they're still not evolved in the green area to say that they are not monkeys, but maybe they figured it out. Anyways, moving to the point. The problem is life is all about decisions. More choices means harder to choose. And on top of that, more information thanks to Google, Facebook, all the apps, great stuff, even harder to choose. All right? The beauty about humans is we create shortcuts. All right? We create these shortcuts to deal with complexities. Right? We do that so that we do not have to every time think, okay, what am I supposed to do after I get up in the morning? Brush my teeth or check my emails? No, you have a routine. Tuck, 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 tuck. It happens every morning automatically, right? We do this in a lot of other things. Now, these shortcuts have created one problem. With great shortcuts comes great traps. And I'll tell you what are those traps. So we'll talk about some of those weaknesses that we've got from the system one. And system two, although knows these things, can't fix it, right? And how companies have used that to their advantage, and how some of those recent internet companies are also using to their advantage. Okay? Interesting enough? I know you have had lunch, but that doesn't mean that you should make your system one feel relaxed. Cool. Move to reciprocity. I scratch your back, you scratch my back. I get you gift, you get me gift. I come for your marriage, you come for my marriage. I have bought you a t-shirt, you get me jeans. It's something that our ancestors did. And it's by default in us. All right? And I'll give some example for that. Let's take the simplest example. Amway. How many of you know Amway? I'm doing this so that you wake up, all right? So it's okay. Amway's biggest model was, they'll tell the users, say, hey, ye sample rakho, use karo yaar, doesn't matter. And most likely you'll pay for it. And $1 billion company created out of that, right? Because we would not feel like going to this guy, hey, I use some little bit of that, now take it back. So the model just takes off. Tupperware, MLM, any MLM business, all right? I'll give a simpler example. You must have seen this scene, right? This is very common across India. I don't know if about South India, but in western part of India, if you go to some of these shops, aiye, aiye, madam, there are cold drink or nashta mangwana. You know what has happened? They've tricked you. We are feeling obligated to reciprocate by buying something. Now think about it. You will say, nee, 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 aisa nahi hota, lekin aisa hi hota hai. We will get into this trap all the time. Now, if you go to the shopkeepers and tell them, why are you doing this? Even they don't know why they're doing it. Someone in the ancestor discovered this weakness or fir wo SOP ban gaya. So even they don't know what they are doing that. But I'm telling you, people feel extremely obligated. Statistical studies have shown that if you give something to the guy who walks to your store, there is a 60% more chance that he'll buy. Scary stats. This is Hare Rama Hare Krishna. How many of you know Hare Rama Hare Krishna? If I offend any of you, don't mind it, but this is data. They do this amazing trick. They walk up to you and say, "Sir, this is Gita for you. A gift from us. Or this is a flower for you." How many of you experienced that? A Gita walk up to you, a flower walk up to you. Okay. Maybe they don't do it anymore because they have been banned. They were banned because they made millions of dollars of donations out of that. Once someone has given a Gita or a flower, there is no way someone can say no for a charity. Because you took an obligation first. And it was not even asked. It just forced onto you. Right? It's a very, very common thing. This is an example of a psychologist who did this. He went to a party and he did this experiment over 3 years. He would give a potential guy a Coke. Aise hi. Ek mere liye laya, ek tumhare liye. Please have it. No one has a problem with a little bit of Hindi here and there, right? Okay, good. And they would say that, and this guy was selling insurance, by the way. He had 80% more success just because he got Coke for someone. So all the accelerator programs who give you free t-shirts, you know what's happening. Any companies which we give you free t-shirts, free bags, although they're giving you salaries, but we are getting the obligation loop. All right? It's a big weakness we have. Let's take some practical examples. How many of you do this? किसी ने मेरे को फॉलो किया मैं उसको फॉलो करूंगा. You must have seen this very often now on sites. Register and get vouchers right now. There's a little bit of flaw. They're saying register and get. What if they said get 5,000 vouchers immediately in fine print, register for it? Right? A personalized letter with a signature. I'll tell you what an experiment did with Freecharge. We took a certain segment of users and I sent out a personalized letter to them when their coupons were sent to them. Okay? And we analyzed the cohort behavior of people who were not sent this letter and people who were sent this letter. 80% of people who were sent the letter are still continuing to be our customers 8 months down the line. We could not just scale it because I could not write that many letters, but if someone could figure that out, it's a problem to solve. Articles. Like this post, please share it with your friends. And yeah, I'll feel obligated because I've free my content consumed here. I read your report, I'll share it with my friends. So these are the applications we see. And this is used in many such ways, right? I only had 5 hours to prepare the presentation. So do your own homework. You'll find them all around you. All right? More so in traditional businesses than organized businesses. And I'll tell you why. Because organized businesses, this is not a B-school learning always. I mean, there is some amount of learning of that, but it's not always a B-school learning. Okay? Next. By the way, this is not Salman Khan's problem. Every one of us has this problem. When we make a commitment, we somehow stick to it. Where is Varun? Do I see him around? Hey dude, you wrote that thing on the tissue paper. Where are you, man? Okay, cool. You wrote that thing on the tissue paper, right? That's called commitment kar diya. Tumhe khud ki bhi nahi sunta after you are back to sober state. So this is called commitment and consistency. Once we do a commitment, and more so when we do a commitment in public, that I am going to invest in a startup today at 10 lakh rupees, check piche aa gaya hai, I will do it. Right? What are the problems or what are the things? This is a very common slip that is given to patients, asked for patients when they are supposed to get the next appointment with the doctor. People have noticed through surveys that when you give this card to be filled up by the patient directly, with the same information he just said, if he writes it on his own, there is a 75% chance that he will not cancel the appointment versus a 40, rather around in terms of double the possibility, right? Just because usne khud se likha, right? You must have seen this slogan contest all the time. I love Rasna because... So when you write why I love Rasna, you actually fall in love with Rasna. It's a fact. It's a psychological fact. Okay? There is a thing. How many of you have known the story that the most naughtiest student in the school is made the monitor? Yeah, I know. Exactly this. Ek baar maine commitment kar liya, to main khud ki bhi nahi sunta. So I will be the nice guy and make everyone quiet. Alright? I'm sure teachers have forgotten this, why they have done it also. It's just a norm in SOP now. The same thing happened with a society in US, which was not very clean. They would not maintain it well. They gave these boards to the guys saying that, would you keep it outside your house? Because your neighborhood guys are not listening. The guy who kept it was actually the worst guy who was given this. But because he kept it super clean. Because usne commitment kar diya, so he had to oblige for that, right? Toys R Us is an amazing example. They would always do this. They would advertise for a product November, December ke time pe heavily. And invariably, that toy will not be available when you go for Christmas shopping. So kisko commitment kar diya? To your kid. Kid has gone to Christmas Toys R Us. The toy is not there. The kid's not coming without a toy. Pakka. What they solved the problem is January and February sales problem by introducing the toy that's come in stock now. Problem solved. Commitment to the kid, it has to be met. Right? So we are having this problem. I can give you n number of examples, but let's look at some of the practical ones. When I put something in a cart or a wish list, there is a very good probability of me buying it. So companies should work aggressively towards getting the guy to add something in the cart. It's like, I was in a store, I put four things. I'm not going to leave the cart just like that. Chalo le leta hun. So it's the trick. Tell a friend, when you share something good or bad about a movie to your friends on Facebook, you are so committed to that review that even if the movie flops, you're not changing your view. Just because you said it was a great movie. I thought Life of Pi was bakwas. But most people said it's great. And they could not change their view after I confronted them. Happens. This is something that you will see on Dropbox. They just tell you to write, why do I love Dropbox? It does not post anywhere, Facebook, nothing. It goes in the database of Dropbox. You think Dropbox is reading this? They don't have to, because why do you love Dropbox? They've already framed you by saying that you love Dropbox. Now they're giving you the because. So you're rationalizing to yourself. And the people write anything, but they're telling themselves, I love Dropbox. And these users who do this are extremely sticky. All right? This is something that you must have seen happening recently, retargeting. So these are the exact bed sheets I saw. And the ad chased me forever. I'm sure you may notice that, right? Bombay, Bangalore search you, it keeps searching you. What you've done by a search is shown some amount of intent. It is kind of like a commitment in some way. And we will consistently follow that and it will act like a guilty pleasure or a guilt feeling that I need to buy this. So I'll tell you what happened. A niece on December 20th on her birthday wanted a PlayStation PSP. And I'm like, okay, let me go to the sites. And my December 1st, I'm looking for the best deal. This thing keeps coming in my ad. PSP. I'm like, shit. Every time I see that, I need to buy that for her. And I had to do it finally. Right? That's the problem of commitment and consistency. Social proof. It's the most applicable thing when it comes to misuse of human weaknesses, and I'll tell you what is the weakness. We tend to believe the wisdom of the crowd. Okay? So when I asked all of you, how many of you have known Freecharge? When 80% of you raised hands, वो 20% automatically हो रही है कि तो आदमी बहुत famous लगता है. It's the wisdom of the crowd. But how do I do this in an online world? How do I make people who are visiting my site say that, dude, so many people are transacting on this site? Okay? I'll give you an example. How many of you know about Mumbai Vada Pav? Mumbai Vada Pav. Okay, good. There are two shops of Vada Pav. One has a huge ass queue and one guy has two people in it. Whose Vada Pav are you having? The queue wala. Natural logic. How do I do this in the online world? I don't know, honestly. It's a good problem to solve. The point is, we tend to take shortcut of decision ki yaar 10 log ja rahe hain to acha hi hoga. Why did you show up for this conference? Exactly the same. When you came, you saw so many people, you thought you had done a good decision. And by the time you go out, you'll feel great because 600 people clapped at the end of the session. That's what happens in movies, by the way. All Friday, Saturday movies in prime locations have people who have been planted to laugh a lot and clap a lot. You don't know that, do you? This is that. You know about laughter tracks. They exist. They've been existing from 60s. Even today, when you watch a soap opera, or not soap opera, comedy serial or anything, there'll be a laughter track with sounding like 100 people are laughing. And you find it funny. So funny, isn't it? This is the biggest problem. We tend to believe a crowd automatically, even when we know it's a recorded laughter track. That's how automatic we are. Okay? Temples, again sensitive topic, but the temples which have the most amount of crowd tend to have the most amount of magical power. Or the other way around, I don't know. Something has been done brilliantly and it works. And I'll give you an example of Siddhivinayak, which is in Bombay. Every Tuesday people walk from their houses to Siddhivinayak. Then one day Amitabh Bachchan walked without shoes. Everyone walked without shoes. Now you go on Tuesday, there is a traffic jam because people are walking to Siddhivinayak. And brilliantly outside Siddhivinayak, there's a whole mela of food business. People walk, go to the temple, have fun, go back home. Tuesday night, happening. McDonald's, over 99 billion served. So how can you be wrong? For an individual dot, right? Doctors. I went to a doctor with idea of our friend Bracto. Great appointment scheduling system, online alert, SMS, and the works. And the comment he gave was the following. Log wait karte hain, tab sochte hain doctor acha hai. That means if they are waiting, only then they're thinking the doctor is worth something. What if they came and there was no patient? Well, technically you should have a software, but the doctor was practical. He's like, dude, I need to have all these people waiting all the time. Tips. You must have seen these jars or somewhere. I'll tell you an incident I had with Rajdhani train. I was on the first dabba, on the first seat. And uske baad seedha gate and there's a server over there. In the morning, if you have traveled by Rajdhani, he'll come with a plate with soft and expect you to put a tip in it. I'll tell you what he did. He came straight with 50 rupees ka note in it. Like, so did someone give him a tip in the toilet? Then I asked him, kya kiya? Bolta, sir, 50 rakhta hu na, to log 10-20 dalte hain. Agar koi kisi ne pehle 10 dal diya, to baki log bhi 10 hi dalte hain. That's how it is. That's how simple it is. Right? We do this automatically. Right? If you see a lot of people putting coins in temple, we'll all put coins. If you see in Tirupati people are putting gold. I don't know, maybe people do that. This is a very common thing. People say that if you want to reuse your linen or towels, it's great for the planet and all that. One scientist did this experiment. He just made a small change. He did not talk about environment or anything. He said, he said, 73% of this hotel's guests use their towels again. One statement. The compliance went up by 30% from where it was. They lied about it. 70% was not the truth. They did one more thing. They said 80% of users who stayed in this room used their linen again. Compliance went up even more. So personalization, even in the groups that we belong to. So let's say this is a group we like. But even if there's a small percentage that, okay, my five friends are doing it, I'll mimic that behavior all the time. There are not enough examples of this, but there are enough online examples. Trending is the perfect example of crowd wisdom. If it's trending, it must be good. And then you wonder, why is it trending? Then you think it must be good. That's why it's trending, or it's funny. And then you wonder sometimes that, did someone actually play a game and got it trending? Maybe they did, I don't know, but it sounds popular. 10,000 startups. 10,000 startups. I'm not making fun of this, but it's a nice strategy to say, oh, there is 500 startups, we have 10,000 startups. Nothing wrong, these are great guys. I'm just saying that this is a very common thing to make it look bigger than what it is. They have all the right intentions though. Bestsellers. How many of you have picked up a book because it was on a bestseller shelf? How many of you just did that automatically? Bestseller. You do that. Go on pura library dekhega and understand. Oh, let's go by the crowd's wisdom. TripAdvisor. We do this a lot, by the way. So when we implemented this, so these are my friends who show up. This is what Facebook does for you. A lot of people put this right at the bottom. Right? At the footer. We brought it right at the right-hand top. The bounce rate of the site went down by 8%. Naman, 8%? Yeah, 8%, right? So he was the guy who was a founding team member. He says, it doesn't work that way, and we had an argument, and we went by data, right? So, yeah, social proof works. There are unlimited examples for it, right? We just go, take an easy decision on what everyone is doing, and it can be manipulated. Liking. A lot of people are laughing because they don't like this guy. But a lot of people love this guy. And they are so irrational about it. Like the guy? Oh, I thought you were liking that guy. We don't think we are influenced by this, but we are. Okay? We tend to do disproportionate amount of favors that people we like. Somehow. People who are better looking always get better salaries. It's a fact. Right? People who create a nice little happy feeling with you tend to get extra favors, right? It happens all the time. Give some examples. Let's go to the Shah Rukh Khan one. The celebrities are using Lux soap. I like Shah Rukh Khan, therefore, I should like Lux soap. I like Sachin Tendulkar, that's why I should buy HDFC life insurance. We do that, by the way. Okay? And that's why celebrities get so much money more than their profession over here. Good cop, bad cop. You must have heard this phrase a lot of times. One guy will act tough and one guy will act cool with you. It's the greatest thing to get something done from someone. Why? Because the tough guy is making it so hard for you. The soft guy comes and says, chal yaar, tera kaam kar deta hu. Isko main sambhal lunga. I'll take care of this guy. You don't worry about it. You will see this in VC meetings also. Telling you. I have my investor over here, so I can't seek more. Ramesh Suresh. It's a very, very magical thing. If someone is like me, in so many ways. Oh, iska surname bhi Shah. You're in Bangalore. Oh, your name is Kunal. Oh, you are also from this school. Oh, you're from this college. Oh, you're also an entrepreneur. When we find similar traits between people, we tend to do more favors to them. So the smartest sales guys will always find a common trait before they walk into the meeting. Sir, you also play golf? I have passes with me. You should go for it. Totally framed. You know why? Because he saw that gaadi mein golf club dikhta hai, so he planned it. A lot of people do that. The reason we have do not have great sales guys, because these are techniques that are taught over there in US. Over here, we are discovering through these conferences. So what I'm saying is people who have this liking will do. I'll tell you one more thing. Anyone who has a name of God in their name or surname is much more likely to be religious than the guy who does not. Can you believe that? It's a fact. Okay, Google, Wikipedia, you'll find enough answers for these stats. It's a very, very common thing. People who have anything to do with a particular profession in their first name or last name tend to do that profession automatically because they feel like someone with a surname lawyer or something which is something like a lawyer, well, he ends up doing something like that. Someone who is Agarwal Shah, even if he's doing a job, ends up doing some entrepreneurship thing sometime. It's a fact. Gupta, all of that. Flattery. We think, yaar, ye banda bahut mujhe bhav de raha hai. He's trying to please me too much. And we are supposed to be on guard against these guys. The fact of the matter is we are all suckers of flattery. Example, I tweet and I watch kitne log ne retweet bhi kiya. Maine Facebook pe post kiya, I actually log in and see kitne log ne like kiya. And don't tell me you guys don't do that. Okay, we all do that. We love flattery. I love people who come to me and say, Kunal, great presentation. I love it, yaar. Why do I lie? Okay? But we will not agree to this, and that's why we get manipulated. We are thinking I'm not getting manipulated, but we are. Okay? I do not get time to prepare this slide, but this is a great example of this being done. Liking. When I say I'm liking something, you're more likely to actually do something for that. iPhone is a fan club. Apple is a fan club. You know what is a fan? Who has love unconditionally. That's a fan. Because I love you and like you so much that even if you launch a phone with just a 1 inch more, I'll take it. I did not put logos of these guys because there was no Wi-Fi over here. I have no disrespect to these companies. These companies have done a brilliant thing. ClearTrip has fans of their UI. Even if they are 200 rupees more expensive, doesn't matter. Main superior being hu, or mera superior being, I have to take from ClearTrip. It's a great positioning to have. People like you for your UI, right? Flipkart was love for the delivery. Now, the scale is a different problem, but their growth did not happen because of ads, to be very, very honest. That's when the branding happened. The transaction happened because of this great delivery that they did. And I think it's commendable to be liked. Right? I went to a school and I asked them, how many of you know e-commerce? Everyone raised hand. I asked them, how many of you know one e-commerce company? Everyone shouted Flipkart. That's great. Right? So there are enough things of making use of liking. I'll tell you one more problem of liking. We tend to do these irrational behavior to be liked also, not just liking someone else. Okay? So liking is two-way. Someone who likes me will get disproportionate favor. I'll give you an example.
what I did.
I was coming once from US, like every Indian, I was asked to get iPads and iPhones and laptops for people. And I was nervous because I walk up to the custom thing. Fortunately, I was reading a book that explained this concept properly. So just when I was walking up to the green channel, I put my bag, I walked up to the other side, I asked the customs guy, sir, thoda pani milega? And he said, ah. And he saw my bag, he could not do anything. These are all great things to learn. If you don't apply them, they are useless. All right? Benjamin Franklin has this policy of always taking small favors from people so that he is liked by everyone. Because you feel that he has a small favor here, so you suddenly start liking this guy. And you do big favor to those guys who give you small favor. I'll tell you, give you an example. You go to an angel and say, I want money, versus you call an angel, sir, I need your 5 minutes of advice. I'm not looking for money. I'm telling you it will work. Not that I've spoken about it, but it will. Because they've already done a small favor to you by giving something of their own being to you already. And they are more likely to do a bigger favor to you. I'll give you another example of VCs again. Commitment and consistency. Ek baar maine commitment kar diya ye CEO ke upar, I'll not let him die quickly. And also, by the way, the reason of learning these things is that we are dealing with humans all the time. VCs, investors, angels, employees, wife who's in stress because you're an entrepreneur, your customers, your vendors, everyone is human. And these principles are not just for consumer businesses. They are for humans who we deal with all the time. Okay? I'll give you another example of liking. When I was starting this company, Naman was my first employee. We did a scam of getting our first few customers. We created a fake profile called as Neha Singh. She was very good looking. She got 5,000 friends in 30 days. And she would regularly keep posting, oh, I'm not well. He's the guy, Naman is the guy who did it, all that, right? So I did not do anything. And one fine day she says, hey guys, have you checked Freecharge.in? Looks pretty cool site. Has anyone tried it? She gets 200 comments in exactly 10 minutes. 198 of them said, they are going to steal your credit card. They are going to loot you. Aisa kuch free nahi hota hai. It's a scam. And there were two positive comments. That was me and Naman. So we were very depressed, by the way. Remember, Naman? 2-3 days we were thinking, what the hell happened? We are a scam now. Actually, what happened is, it was a good problem. No one believed it for real. It's a good problem to solve, and we solved that problem. It was fun. But what happened is, liking a fake person got us our first 200 transactions. Believe it or not. And it always works. Scarcity. It's an amazing thing. Apple uses it all the time, and every time people fall for it. And there's a fun in standing in this queue because it's like the old days when movies used to run for golden jubilees and getting a first day, first night show was like, you know what? I'm going for the Friday night movie. It was the exact same thing, scarcity. Now there are multiplexes, there is no scarcity. But that was the core of the model, that movies would work for golden jubilee because the first week guy will be proud, second week guy will be proud, the 49th week guy is like, dude, everyone has seen it, I need to see it too. Take an example. Coke launched sometime in the 70s, New Coke. And they told that the old Coke is going to be shut down forever in 30 days. Huge protest. Scarcity, people bought in all the quantities that they could. It was a ploy that they did. And people loved Coke even more, the old one. Commitment. The smartest real estate agents, actually let's talk about the dumb real estate agents. Sir, aap 11 baje aana, aap 12 baje aana, aap 1 baje aana, aap 2 baje aana. Char appointment fixed, I'll show the same house to 4 people. The smartest guy will call all 4 of them at exactly 1 p.m. And they'll be like, house is crowded because there's so many people walking into the apartment. Suddenly you feel the apartment is really hot. And yeah, it works. Suddenly you feel, ye haath se chala jayega. And you end up paying more. It happens all the time. I'll give you this beautiful example of this particular two brothers. In 1930s, they used to run a tailor shop for stitching suits. And one guy would pretend that he's deaf. And he'll be talking to this guy who's come for the suit, take a measurement. The other brother will be on the first floor, who's the in charge of the factory. And after he's done taking the measurement, he'll say, hey, Jerry, how much for this particular great cloth suit? And that guy would shout, $45. This guy, in a fraction of a second, would tell the gentleman, sir, $25. You know what happened? The guy who heard 45 and 25 bought the suit without thinking anything. Because suddenly there is scarcity, I will not get that same price, just get it. The suit was actually worth $15. And these guys did it for years and years. The same scam. Alright? Sold out. I don't know if you've seen, but online mein nahi hota, offline mein kaafi hota hai. One piece sold out. Still kept there. I don't know why. So I get curious. Sold out kyun ho gaya ye? Achha item chalta hoga. It must be doing really well. So I say, hey, can I get one of them too? Dekho, agar kuch hoga to. And he's like, nahi sir, no, it's done. Then he'll just come back and say, sir, I got one piece. That order is still not confirmed because this guy is not paid. You want it? I want it because it's not available. Happens all the time. Okay? I'll talk about this mail example. There's a company which did a brilliant scam. And I'm telling this is a scam because they were banned. Some of these continue. Like Apple. The thing that this company did is they would send out 50,000 letters predicting that who's going to win the next football match to random people and say that we are a prediction company. Hamare prediction se logo ke millions of dollars, pounds have been made. You should also try us. They would send 50,000. In 25,000, they would say team A will win. In 25,000, they say team B will win. So naturally, 50% of them got the right prediction. So they would eliminate the first set which got rank prediction. They send 25,000 again a new prediction with 12,500 with A and 12,500 again with B. And yes, 12,500 came true because one of the team won again. They would do this again. By the time it would come to the last 5,000, people would send them check. Because they will say after the third prediction, the prediction stop for free. So people would send them check and continue the predictions. Scarcity created. Right? So, although these sound like cons to you, there are some human weaknesses we are discussing over here. I'm not saying that you should start an illegal business. And I can always debate that if the existing businesses are all legal or not. But anyways, that's a different topic. We have a natural tendency to react more to loss than gain. And that's why scarcity works. Okay? 2.3 times more. Is the empirical formula established? Someone has already won the Nobel Prize for it, so it's over. Proven. I'll give you an example. If you tell someone, get $50 worth of extra stuff today for buying online, versus saying, you could lose $50 of extra discount today if you don't buy online. 2.3 times. We've tried this multiple times at Freecharge. It's worked. Surit, you are there, right, somewhere? The recent experiment you have conducted, and you saw the results when we implemented this. It does work. We react disproportionately to loss. And we are absolutely irrational about it. This is exactly the behavior of stock market. When stock market crashes, the good thing is to just book your profit, get out, but we hold on to it because the loss has felt a lot more, so we continue, right? There's an experiment one guy does in a, I don't know which Stanford University or Harvard. He sells a $20 note in the classroom, and he'll ask students to bid on it, incremental of $1 each. The only rule is that the first guy and the runner-up both pay. So it'll start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The funny things happen at 14. The guy at 14, the 13 guy is feeling, hey, I'm going to lose $13 if I don't win this. He puts 14, 15, 16, 17. On an average, that professor has sold the note for at least $220 every time in the classroom. Because the second guy felt the loss. So he did irrational thing of not wanting to lose money. This is something that is there. There are n number of examples if you look up the web. But you should try this in your business. In your appraisals. One seat left. This is Make My Trip yesterday. One seat, two seat, one seat, one seat, one seat. Great, I should take it. Pepper fry. All the offers they have sent me. Offer ends today. Only for today. Ends today. Just for today. They are making it sound like a loss for me. Groupon. Two things. First of all, this is, by the way, the first principle. Social proof. 460 people have bought it. Second one is 18 hours, 13 minutes left. People have made a huge mistake in India when they copied Groupon. Groupon works on scarcity. Ye coupon aaj hi hai, it's for today, for 24 hours, take it. In India, we made a shopping mall out of coupons. If there is no scarcity of coupons, there is no urgency to buy them, there is no impulse behavior. Fast forward, there are no Groupon clones left. Means there are companies who are doing stuff, but the model is with abundance has gone away. Groupon India still continue to keep one primary deal and side deals. But all other did almost a shopping mall out of deals. It doesn't work. Google Glass applications are now closed. Suddenly I need to have it. Gmail used to only get by invite only, if you remember, when it started off, right? Scarcity makes it very desirable. Authority. What is authority? Let's take examples. You know this movie, Catch Me If You Can. He dressed up as a pilot, doctor, military guy, everyone. The common trait was he was wearing a uniform. We tend to disproportionately believe anyone who wears a uniform or has a title or a degree which feels like a uniform. If I had told you before the session, start of the session, that I am, by the way, PhD in human psychology from Stanford University, this lecture would have meant totally different for you. I'm better than them. People who have authority can brainwash an entire country and make them believe he's God. Yeah, maybe. This guy, Madoff, pulled off a Ponzi scheme. Why? Because he was a chairman of Nasdaq. He could just tell people to invest more and more with him. And he's in jail now, but I think amazing authority to have, right? I'll tell you one more thing. We tend to respect a lot more people who come with a suit and a tie. We think it's uncool in startup world to do that, but the English were not foolish. They did it because it establishes authority. English were the guys who brought a lot of the hierarchies. They used to wear wigs. They would have a certain coat. All of that established hierarchies. We tend to naturally respect hierarchies. Okay? This was an amazing experiment done by a guy called as Milgram. And he told these guys, who came for experiment, that there is a patient on the other side and we have to test how much of current he can take one by one. And this guy was dressed as a poker face psychologist in full apron in a great university's campus. The suspects, I mean, the guy who came in, so the act, there was an actor on the other side who was getting the current, right? They would say 10 volts, 20 volts, 30 volts, this, that. Most people who took the experiment went all the way, and this was almost 440. Just because the guy on the apron was saying, I am telling you, I know better, just do it. People followed that. Knowing that that guy is screaming, saying that stop this, even then they respected authority. I'll give you another example. Let's say a cop tries to manage traffic and he's not wearing his uniform. We'll think he's just somebody. But I'll do another side. A guy who's dressed up like a watchman, the torn shirt, will still respect him just because he's wearing a uniform. We have this natural flaw of respecting authority. You all know this, right? I'm CEO. The great thing about hiring in startup is you can give them great titles. You are a software engineer at Amazon. Now you are a VP. We all love authority, by the way, okay? As featured on TechCrunch, this, authority. Times of India, all of that. Mayorship, we all know that. This is an interesting one. I always used to wonder, there's a clean UI site and there is a very heavy site like Make My Trip. If things have to be believed, we should look at the cleaner one, right? It's simple, faster, price almost the same. So Make My Trip did revert to this simpler design. They reverted back to this, probably last week, I don't know when, to this big, massive thing. What I realize is that in India, especially, clean is not beautiful yet. I'll give you an example. Let's go to Big Bazaar. A total chaos. But the consumer thinks it's a great place to be. There's a place in Bangalore, Chennai also, which has some other concept, huge mass market format, not very organized. I'll give you another example. This guy sells everything, gold, diamond, this, that, so this jeweler is better. You don't respect niche categories. Oh, for diamond you need to go here, for gold you need to go here. We are all fools for someone who's larger than life. So this happens a lot in formats of electronic stores. The LCD wall, whoever has the biggest wall is perceived to be a bigger retailer and thereby having more choices and thereby having better deals. It's the authority that we are creating. So this is the thing that I want to talk about, is that we need to apply these to our businesses, in our lives, in our day-to-day interactions. I'm not saying that you have to become a con man. I'm just saying that these are things available in the marketing world for you to apply in your consumer product, your web product, your negotiation with an angel, your negotiation with your employer for better salary, everything. Right? And you can make things better to your advantage if you start studying this. I've only addressed 6 of them. There are close to around 120 odd biases that we have as humans. Right? Now, it's my subject that I enjoy this, so I read a lot. You don't need to read this, but YouTube, you send these experiments done in real. And these are making huge difference to the stats. They're not small differences. It's not like 1% increment ho gaya. It's a 30% increment, 20% increment, which is not a small number. So what I would request for all of people is to do, try some of these principles and try it very soon before you forget, right? And you'll enjoy it, right? And there are more and more possibilities of these to be applied in businesses, more and more of these to be kind of made an API into, create an app out of it. Multiple things are possible. So I would like to end the session with this and I'll take more questions. Thanks a lot.